Hello, hello, hello. Today is Thursday, July 4, 2024. It's the 4th of July, national holiday in the United States. It's our Independence Day. Yeah, there was a time that we were not independent, that we were ruled by the British. Solution to problem 205. There were many correct solutions. It was an easy problem. Roughly speaking, about 20 correct solutions. It's a problem that was on one of my homework assignments at MIT. So you could have found it there. That means you could also have found the solutions there. What follows here is Keith Norman's solutions. All his solutions are nice and to the point. Thank you, Keith, very much.
This is Keith's solution to Walter Lewin's problem 205. And the relevant lectures from 801 are 15, 16, 19, and also module 20.04. Some good stuff in there, even if you think you know it. I always like to go over how Walter does things, because I often find he has a different approach, even on simple problems. He has a different approach sometimes to how I would do it. But anyway, okay, we have a rod, some sort of, here's my simulated rod, and a bullet hits the rod, passes through the rod, and the rod is pivoted about its centre of mass, and so it spins and the bullet carries on. We have to regard that somehow the bullet goes through the rod without destroying it, so it and it doesn't affect its mass or its moment of inertia. But the bullet does lose speed, which is important. Okay, we can't use conservation of linear momentum because the pivot, as the bullet strikes the rod, will have a reaction. And we don't know what that is off the top of our head. We can't use conservation of energy either, because this is an inelastic collision. If you're not sure about all of that, lecture 16 of 801 is where Walter Lewin deals with elastic and inelastic collisions. But we can use conservation of angular momentum, which is what we're going to do, but it is about the pivot point. If you try and take it about anywhere else, then the reaction at the pivot, will contribute a torque to what you're trying to do. But at the pivot, any reaction, because it's multiplied vectorially by the radial distance from the pivot, that's going to be zero. Radial distance is zero, so there is no torque at the pivot, hence conservation of angular momentum. Okay, the initial, and we consider the system. It's important to consider the whole system. The angular momentum is conserved. Okay, the initial angular momentum is only due to the bullet, and it's this term here. It's mv times l over 4, which is the perpendicular distance. I am taking it from the diagram that the bullet hits the rod perpendicularly. So after it leaves, it has a new velocity v prime, initially velocity v, now it's got v prime. So it's contribution to the angular momentum after the impact is this term here, but the rod is now spinning. It can't move away because of the pivot, but it can spin, and I've said it will spin with some omega p, about its omega about the pivot point, and it will be the contribution here is I about p, where I is the moment of inertia about the pivot of the rod, times omega. And when you do consider moments of inertia, it must be about an axis. You can't just say the rod has a moment of inertia. That's meaningless. It has to be about an axis. And in this case, the axis is there, vertical to the paper. So I then substitute for the moment of inertia of the rod about its centre of mass, which is this term here. If you're not sure how to derive that, module 20.04, substituting that in for omega p, I get this expression, which reduces to that, feed in the values, and I get a very convenient 2.7 radians per second, which is obviously in this direction. Angular speed, although strictly we should say all these are vectors, and it's an angular velocity that way, if that makes sense to you down there. But because it's really a one-dimensional problem, we can ignore vectors on this occasion. Anyway, that's it. Final answer, 2.7 radians per second in a clockwise direction, angular velocity. Thank you.